Field is more interesting because it's got anthills in it, so if you see something from go up to, so it's going over anthills.
It's the 2nd of September, and we're off on a bee walk around the Pillertons. It's one of Norman's walks, but he's in Snowdonia, so Keith and Alan take on the job of leading the walk.
Let's have your best profile.
If there's any children, they've got kids, haven't they?
As we stop for lunch and huddle down behind some straw bales, we meet the A-team, who pass on a few words of advice. When we get to the end of the walk, we find the same chicken that saw us off at the beginning, waiting for us at the finish. I wonder how he got here. The following Sunday, we're off on a C-plus walk from Lower Shuckburgh, led by Sheila and Stephen. It's a beautiful day, and we start our walk by climbing up through the Shuckburgh estate. We stop for a short coffee break at the fish ponds below Napton on the hill, and then we're off again, up into the village. As we get towards the end of the walk, the pace seems to quicken.
He must be sailing at Drake Hot Water because he comes round on his electric bike with his life jacket and everything.
So he's got a life jacket on.
Yeah, he's got his, yeah. Because I suppose he can only carry so much stuff. So where's his life jacket?
Thursday the 13th of September, a midweek walk, starting from Ufton, led by Phil and Mary. Icomb on the 16th of September. It's a bee walk led by Ray. After many years with the club, it's his last walk with Rugby Ramblers. We stopped for lunch and a bit of shopping at Boughton on the Water.